Welcome everybody to another video of Ancient Greece Reloaded. Today we will talk about the famous Hesperides, the nymphs of the sunset. By the way, if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel so as to stay tuned for upcoming videos. The Hesperides in Greek mythology were the nymphs of the sunset. Different sources name different parents for the Hesperides. They are sometimes portrayed as the evening daughters of Nyx, either alone or with darkness, in accord with the way Eos, and the farthermost east in Colchis, is the daughter of the Titan Hyperion. The Hesperides are also listed as the daughters of Atlas and Hesperes, or of Phorcys and Ceto, or of Zeus and Themis. In a Roman literature source, the nymphs are simply said to be the daughters of Hesperos, embodiment of the West. It was usually thought that there were three Hesperides, although some sources name four or seven. For instance, Apollonius of Rhodes gives the number of three with their names as Aigle, Erytheis, and Hespere. The Hesperides tend a blissful garden in the far west corner of the world, located near the Atlas Mountains in North Africa, at the edge of the encircling Oceanus, the world ocean. According to Sicilian Greek poet Stesichorus in his poem of The Song of Geryon and the Greek geographer Strabo in his book Geographica, Volume 3, the Garden of Hesperides is located in Tartessos, a location placed in the south of the Iberian Peninsula. By ancient Roman times, the Garden of the Hesperides had lost its archaic place in religion and had dwindled to a poetic convention, in which form it was revived in Renaissance poetry to refer both to the garden and to the nymphs that dwelt there. The so-called Garden of Hesperides belonged to the goddess Hera, in which there was a grove of apple trees that bore golden apples. The golden apples were believed to give immortality to anyone who consumed them. Not trusting the Hesperides to guard the apple trees on their own, Hera also placed a 100-headed dragon named Ladon that never slept. A golden apple that was taken from the garden of the Hesperides was what eventually caused the Trojan War. Eris, goddess of strife, managed to steal an apple from the garden and scribed the words to the fairest and threw it amidst the goddesses that attended at a wedding she was not invited to. The apple was then given by Paris, prince of Troy, to Aphrodite, who promised to give him Helen as his wife, thus triggering the events of the Trojan War. The Hesperides and their garden were also one of the tasks that were given during the labors of Hercules. Eurystheus, not counting the slaying of the Lernaean Hydra, nor the cleaning of the Aegean stables, gave two extra tasks to Hercules. One of them was to steal the apples from the garden of Hesperides. Heracles successfully managed to get the apples from the garden and bring them back to Erytheus. In more detail, finally making his way to the garden of Hesperides, Heracles tricked Atlas into retrieving one of the golden apples for him, by offering to hold up the heavens for a little while. Atlas was able to take them as, in this version, he was the father or otherwise related to the Hesperides. This would have made this task, like the Hydra and the Aegean stables, void because he had received help. Upon his return, Atlas decided that he did not want to take the heavens back, and instead offered to deliver the apples himself. But Heracles tricked him again by agreeing to take this place on the condition that Atlas relieved him temporarily so that Hercules could make his cloak more comfortable. Atlas agreed, but Heracles reneged and walked away, carrying the apples. According to an alternative version, Heracles slew Ladon instead and stole the apples. There's another variation to the story where Heracles was the only person to steal the apples other than Perseus, although Athena later returned the apples to the rightful place in the garden. They're considered by some to be the same apples of joy that tempted Atalanta, as opposed to the apple of discord used by Ares to start a beauty contest on Olympus, which caused the siege of Troy. On Attic pottery, especially from the late 5th century, Heracles is depicted sitting in bliss in the gardens of the Hesperides, attended by the maidens. What is more, the Argonauts also did encounter the Hesperides, and the story goes as follows. After the hero Heracles killed Ladon and stole the golden apples, the Argonauts during their journey came to the Hesperian plain the next day. The band of heroes asked for the mercy of the Hesperides to guide them to a source of water in order to replenish their thirst. The goddesses, pitying the young men, directed them to a spring created by Heracles, who likewise, longing for a draught while wandering the land, smote a rock near Lake Triton, after which the water gushed out. Finally, according to the author's account, the Hesperides did not have the golden apples. Instead, they possessed flocks of sheep, which excelled in beauty and were therefore called for their beauty, as the poets might do, golden apples, just as Aphrodite is called golden because of her loveliness. Others also say that it was because the sheep had peculiar color like gold that they got this designation. This version further states that Dragon was the name of the shepherd of the sheep, a man who excelled in strength of body and courage, who guarded the sheep and slew any who might dare to carry them off. Let us finish with the following saying. Art is long, life is short. Hippocrates. That being said, remember guys to hit the like button and to subscribe to our channel. It would help us a lot. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for upcoming videos.